Hi, welcome to PNV Technical Hub. In this session, we'll see how to filter the data from XML file with XPath queries using ASP.NET. In our earlier session, we saw how to save the data into an XML file and as well as how to restrict duplicate entries into an XML file using ASP.NET. So, we are already aware of XPath queries. If you are unaware of it, please watch my earlier video sessions, which will be available in seovirendra.blogspot.in. Otherwise, it will be available in PNV Technical Hub in YouTube channel. So, in our current session, let's target how we are going to use a XPath queries in our implementations. So, generally, by using XPath query facilitate, it's in a query language. It facilitates us to, you know, process the XML documents. So by using a select node method, suppose if I want to, in earlier session, we are going to, you know, restrict the data of duplicate entry based on a single attribute. So, but if you want to make this as with multiple attributes, we can use and as an concatenate an operator, and there you can pass the number of attributes, whatever that you want to target. So we'll see a sample, you know, filtration statements, XPath query statements, so that we can understand how filtering process will take in place into your consideration. So consider if I want to, you know, filter the multiple number of attributes. See, we already have a books related information. Books has a three columns. Say for example, three entities we have, that is name, and other is author, and other is version. Suppose I don't want to allow a record based on the, you know, duplicate record based on the name, author, and version. So in order to accomplish this task, so this query we worked it up to @name equal to txt box name dot text. And if you want to do for other, you have to use an and as a concatenator operator and @ with your next attribute, and you can pass your text box and as a concatenation operator @ your column means your attribute, and you can pass the version of the text. In this way, we'll filter the data. This data will be written as an XML node list. Similarly, if you want to read entire XML data, so simply whatever the, you know, root element slash is the parent element, you can pass the root element and slash parent element and read that information whatever you want. And say for example, if you want to filter the data with a contains method, here we have a contains method. Say for example, I have a book, my book name starts with W, or it contains a wing. The book name whose name contains wing, only those information will be available for us. So like in SQL Server, we have a like operator. Similarly, this contains will help us to, you know, fetch the data wherever we found a particular string. So this is the syntax. So this is the attribute name. Here you have to use a contains as operator dot and single quotes. You can pass whatever the name that you want. So in this way, we fetch the list. So these are the different types of, you know, XPath queries that which we'll use for the filtration of the data. So this is a existing XML file. So my file contains books list, book name. So name, wings of fire, author, version, something like author, version, here are different versions of that. So if you want to know the earlier example, so which will be available in this, you know, below link, you can fetch it. So this example, so in order to work with, you know, XML file, these are the steps that we want to follow. Step number one is you have to open the Visual Studio and click on the project, then select empty website. You can implement this implementation either in console application also as per the requirement. The base business logic is similar and same for any of the type of application, whether it would be Windows or whether it would be a console application or anywhere you can use web application. So anywhere you can use the same terms. So samples of web application will vary from normal website to MVC based applications. So here you can provide the name of the application as the XML demo and click on OK. Then go to the Solution Explorer and right click on your project and click on New Folder. So you can name the folder name as a file. So because we have to accommodate our XML file there itself. Now design the form with the following. You can design the form as per the requirement. So for this, right click on the add new item, select the web form name as insert employee. So you can give the name, whatever the name that you are comfortable, and you can pass the, you know, respective data. So in order to accomplish all these steps, I'm going to open my Visual Studio. So click on Visual Studio. I opened my earlier example. I have an earlier example. So we are going to continue this earlier example. Click on add new item. So restrict with multi attributes. Go to the copy the table section and paste here. Copy the styling section also and close the style tag. Use the namespaces which are related for XML using system.xml, system.xml path, and system.io. Copy the code and paste in button click event. I pasted my code. My code was available in button click. So now earlier I checked with only the name. Just go to our XML file. We have three attributes. One is name, and other is other, and other is version. So here what I'm trying to do is I will introduce, you know, rest of versions also. Sorry, rest of attributes also. So this is name, and I want to get the other information. So I want to check with other also. Plus txt other name dot. And version. So in this I am filter the data. So just now what we are going to see, it will checks for the same name, existence of the same name, existence of the author, and existence of a version. So now I am executing this one. Magic of thinking. So here I will pass the data, so which is similar, which is available in the XML file. So David's calls, and which is 3.8.1. So book name is already available in the directory. Suppose if I use 3.8.3, so I click on this. Again, data inserted successfully. You can check your XML file. You got a 3.8.3. So it always checks for the, you know, uniqueness of each and every attribute. In this way, we'll save the data. So without entering the possible duplicate values, this is one type of thing which we saw in our XPath queries. And next implementation for selecting entire XML data. If you want to select entire XML data and to reproduce the same thing in our document or wherever you want, just we can, you know, check. So I want to add a new file, like to name as add new item, fetch data. I'll name my document as fetch data. Go to the design, go to the toolbox, choose text box, sorry, button. So in this button, I want to pass a text to the button as get data. I'd like to change my ID of this control. So for better standards, I'm using SPTN get data. So double click on this, use the namespace using system.xml. Similarly, using system.xml.xpath. Similarly, we want to fetch the data from the IO, so from the folder. So in order to work with the files, you have to use the system.io namespace. Now my requirement is to fetch the data from my folder, and entire data I want to fetch it. So in order to accomplish this task, we have to, you know, understand the path of my XML file. So once I know the path of the XML file, I will load my document. So thereby I can, you know, I can pass my query to fetch the data. So first thing is, so I would like to, you know, declare a variable. So name it as a path equal to string.empty. So once I did this one, so I would like to assign path. So in order to locate my path, use a service server dot map path and use a tilt operator in order to represent my root folder. So here this is my folder name slash plus, and my XML file name is, rename it, my XML file, books info, double quotes, bookinfo.xml. So this is my path of my XML file. So we already aware that in order to work with an XML, we have to use an XML document as a class. So I'm using doc equal to new XML document. So I want to load my file. So in order to load my file, we will use doc.load. And so in order to load a particular file, we have to pass the path of our XML. So here I want to pass my XPath query. I want to write my XPath query. So always if I use a dot dot select node, it always returns an XML node list. So means which contains a list of data. So in order to provide XML node list, I can create an object for this XNL list. This is an object, and here my document data is available in the doc dot, so select nodes. So here, so this method facilitate us to pass our query, whatever the query that we wish to pass. So here I'm using, we have to pass our root element, so, and as well as we have to pass our parent element. My root element is books list. Similarly, my parent is book. Here my requirement is to read entire XML information into my document. That's my reference. So whatever the data that is available, the data will be here itself. This is a list. So in order to read a list information, I would like to use a for loop for int I equal to 0, I less than XNL list. dot count I plus plus. Now I want to read, you know, three attributes information. I have a three attributes. One is book name, and other is, first I would like to declare the variables. Other is author, and other is version. So in order to read this information, so I would like to use XML list. I have my list of I. So in order to read this information, my information is available in the attributes part, right? These are the attributes. So in order to fetch these attributes, we can make use of attributes of double quotes. You can give the name of the attributes, or else you can pass the index of your attribute. Say for example, here index refers me means, so this is your zero, name is zero index, author is first index, so this is second index, like that you can pass. But you know, as per the best practices technique, instead of indexes you have to pass the attribute name only, so which is a good technique, because if you change order of your versions, or if you want to change the order of your attributes, then automatically your indexes may depicts you in a wrong direction. That is the reason, try to take your attribute name instead of indexes, which is the best practice. So similarly for author and similarly for version is the same thing. Just to copy the exactly how it was the attribute, same names you can copy and paste here. So from your book info XML. So this is my version. Now my data is available for me. I want to represent this data in my response.writeline. So I want to display this data with my, you know, in my form only. So response.write. So here, so I would like to format by data by using string.format. So I'll use details, or I'll make the use details are 0. I would like to provide 3 space 1. I would like to provide 3 space 2, comma, book name, comma, author, comma, version. So I'm passing three indexed values to my string dot format. So and then I will use br tag, because so we have a multiple records, right? If you want to use br records, everything will be accommodated in a single line. That's the reason where I want to present my data in br tag. So just I want a line break once we're done with this thing, once we're done with the first record. So now execute my fetch data.aspx page, and I'll click on get data button. So we are going to use, so we'll got an XML information. So the thing is, for attributes we have an inner text, so try to use the inner text, then only you will get the data. Otherwise you will get it as an XML form, XML namespace of this one. Use inner text, just execute your form, click on get data. You'll get Wings of Fire, APJ Abdul Kalam version 1.3, Magic of Thinking, David Scotch 3.0. Like this, you will get the data. In this way, we'll read entire data into a document by using your select notes method. I think this was pretty clear for you, and even this source code will be available in my blog. I will provide you the source code, you know, URL address of my blog at the end of this video. Okay, in this way we will try to, you know, fetch the entire information. Suppose if I want to fetch only particular named based records, then how can we achieve this one? We can achieve with the help of a contains method. Here we would like to use a contains method. So for this I would like to consider one more form. So go to your project, right click on your project, click on add new item. So in this section, just use filter data as a name of your file. So consider button use text as get filtered data and pass your ID btn get data. Double click on this button. So this is your button click event. Okay, try to copy paste the code which is available in the form. First copy paste the namespace. Then copy paste the, here we have to change this part only. In select nodes part only we are going to change our thing. So here what we have to do is, in order to select a particular thing, if you want to apply our contents on any of the attribute, so for attribute you have to use @ before starting of attribute. So our attribute is name. I want to make use to apply on the name itself, name of contains. You can use contains. So use dot sub wings. I placed in the single quote. So just I'll close the square brace, my square brace. And here we have totally two square braces available. Just close all the two square braces. We will read the data. Whatever the data is filtered, that we'll read from here. So now execute this one. Click on get filter data. So I'm re-executing the same. I would like to get the data with the, means the name which starts with the total data will be available. If I use T small. So when I click on this get data, you won't get the data because it always be in a case sensitive mode, so that you have to use exact things. So in this way, we are trying to filter the data with the help of contains method. So dot represents your starting part of your string. It refers starting part of your string. So similarly, you can try with ending part, and you can try with any part of the string, all those things. Okay, in this way we'll work with the filtration of our data. Source code of this video will be available in this URL address. You can get it and work on it. And if you have any queries on this, please make a comment on this video so that we can address what are the queries that you have. Please do subscribe with us, and we have a Facebook page named as PNV Technical Hub. Like us and stay tuned for latest updates on technical things which are related to .NET, SQL Server and services stuff. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.